Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission System. And this is lecture number 5.3. We are going to discuss about the gear failure. The topic is gear failure and its types. So in the earlier two lectures on the gear design, we discussed the different types of gear drive, law of gearing, types of gear profile, pressure angle. We defined the gear nomenclature, backlash, conjugate action, interference and undercutting. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the different types of gear failure and state the methods of avoiding the gear failure. Gear failure. So, look at some of the images collected on the gear failure. So, this is the failure of a boat gear. So, the transmission at the end of the differential, there is a gear. So, this is the failure of the gear. And this is the marine gear. So, look at here, there is removal of material. The tooth profile, it is missing here. It is because of the erosion and the corrosion and the overloading of the gear tooth. And this is the quenching crack, improper quenching. So, there is a crack on the gear blank. And here it is bending due to the overloading of the gear tooth. And this is here again you may find the pitting effect on the surface of the gear tooth. So, there are some removal of material. And this is again gear failure in the generator due to the lubrication problem. Again, there will be wear, removal of material, damage of the complete tooth. So, these are all the some of the images of the gear failure. So, metal gear fail due to the many reasons. Assessing the gear damage is a challenging task in industrial application. And some of the observations, the causes of the gear failure are grouped into three categories. One is gear problem. Because of the manufacture of the gear, the workmanship, design and material selection on the gear. So, because of the gear problem, there is 36% of failure. Because of the operator problem, the person who is working, operating the gear or gearbox. So, the operator problem, because of erroneous operation, improper maintenance and wear, etc. There are many reasons for operator problem. 47% of the failure due to the operator problem or operation problem. And external problem. Some inclusion of some foreign material or drive disturbances. So, because of the external trouble, there are 17% gear failure. So, the major gear problem and the operator problem. So, we will see different types of gear failure and reasons for the gear failure in this presentation. Why gear fails? An error in the design. The design error may be due to the causes like improper gear geometry, use of wrong material, quality and lubrication. Improper selection of, improper checking of the quality and improper design of the lubricating system to the gear in the operating conditions. Then application error. The application error can be due to the problem like vibration, mounting and installation, cooling and maintenance. So, improper maintenance, improper cooling of the gear blank and improper mounting and installation, and there is vibration because of the adverse working condition, there is vibration in the system. And manufacturing error. So, manufacturing error can be in the form of mistakes in the machining or the problem of heat treatment process. So, the machining failure or mistakes in the machining process or in the heat treatment, improper heat treating or the temperature is not maintained properly during the heat treating process. These are all the different reasons for the failure of the gear. There are 5 different types of gear failure. Bending fatigue, pitting effect, micro pitting, scuffing and wear. So, these are all the different types of gear failure. So, we will see one by one in detail. First, the bending failure. So, the bending fatigue failure is the result of cyclic bending stress at the tooth root. So, it may be due to increased dynamic loading on the gear tooth. So, first initially, there are three levels of the bending fatigue failure: crack nucleation, crack propagation, and final unstable fracture. So, there will be small crack formation at the root of the gear tooth, and then even if you do not notice the crack and continuously run the gear, the crack will propagate to the entire width of the gear blank, and finally it will cause the unstable fracture. So look at here, the tooth, there is a complete fracture, so it should be avoided. So first we have to properly check the gear blank when it is not in working condition, and we have to identify if there is any crack nucleation. If it is there, then we have to repair and remove the gear blank. Reason for bending fatigue failure are overload as well as cyclic stressing beyond the endurance of the gear tooth material. So this is again a bending fatigue failure of the gear tooth. And pitting failure are attributed to the surface contact stress along the number of stress cycles. Initial pitting takes place with the small pit areas in localized section of the gear tooth. This ranges from the diameter of 0.015 to 0.03 inches in diameter. And these are all the pitting failure. So, these are all the some of the pitting failure. So, removal of the material. And the solution are reduction in the contact stress on the gear surface. So, the stress on the surface to be reduced to avoid the pitting failure. And micro level pitting, micro pitting. So, it is also kind of contact fatigue. Causes of micro pitting are high surface load along the heat generation. So, the heat generation, it may be due to the improper lubrication. So, when there is improper or insufficient lubrication on the gear blank, so that it leads to micro level pitting. This consequently thins the lubrication film and eventually leading to marginal lubrication. So, the heat generation will reduce the effect of lubrication and leads to micro pitting. The solution can be improving the surface finish during the manufacturing of the gear. So, that is one way. So, there should not be any even small micro level, small pitting on the surface. So, that will lead to heat generation, improper lubrication, and then finally some removal of material on the surface of the gear teeth. Then scuffing or scoring. Scuffing or scoring is a severe type of adhesive wear which instantly damage the tooth surface that are in relative motion. So, look at the surface removal of the material. So, it is adhesive wear is called as scuffing or scoring. Lubricant and lubrication conditions are responsible for scuffing damage. So, the lubrication failure, improper lubrication, these are all the reasons for the scuffing damage. Solution can be downing of the temperature in the mesh area. Other solutions are using the lubricant that has extreme pressure additive or honing, etc. So, the lubrication, quality of the lubricant is to be improved by proper additives so that we can minimize the effect of scoring or adhesive wear on the surface of the gear teeth. Then wear is continuous abrasive process of material removal from the matting gear teeth that happens with or without abrasive particle in the lubricating oil. So, removal of material from the matting gear is called as wear. It takes place with the metal gradually wearing away from the contact point of the gear teeth. So, there is moderate wear, comes up the type of contact pattern where a metal gets removed from both the addendum and the dedendum tooth surfaces. The cause may be lubricant contamination. It cannot be avoided sometimes due to the certain limitations in the operating condition like gear speed, lubricant viscosity, and the temperature. Then these are all the some of the images on the wear of the gear surface, wear on the gear surface, and the solution can be total replacement of splash fed lubricating system to the positive spray system. Further, a way to solve this problem can be reducing the gear load, as also changing the gear geometry, material, or even the hardness of the gear surface. So the increasing the hardness of the surface by proper heat treatment process. Then abrasive wear is characterized by lapped surfaces that has problem on the surface where the tooth contacts. This can show up in the form of radial scratches and or grooves on the surface. This can take place shortly after commencement of the new installation, even on the open gearing. The cause is generally particles in the lubricating system. That is what abrasive wear. So the wear removal of the material is caused by the abrasive particle included in the gear drive along with the lubricating oil. The solution can range from prior cleaning of the gearbox and the lubricating system before use. Other solutions are high viscosity oil, changing filter, are using more fine replacement filter along with the periodic oil changes. So when the lubricating oil is used in the gear blank, so it is recirculated. So when the oil is recirculated, the abrasive, the wear material, metal particles are carried along with the oil. Sometimes in the recirculation of the lubricating oil, the metal particles will return to the gear surface, which causes this kind of abrasive wear. So we require proper fine filtering system for the lubricants so that we can avoid the particle entry into the gear. Corrosive wear is marked by visible surface deterioration. The main reason for corrosive wear is the chemical reaction of active ingredients found in the lubricants. This may be acid, foreign body particulates, moisture, extreme pressure additives, etc. So this is the corrosion, the wear removal of material due to the corrosive nature of the lubricant or some additives in the lubricants. Solution range from checking oil periodically for breakdown and change at regular gap. The other solution is sealing of the gear that are exposed to liquid and the chemical, etc. So these are all the method to avoid the corrosive wear in the gear. Now, how to minimize the gear failure? There are different methods. So install good housekeeping procedure for the maintenance of the gear. Handle the gear with attention. Follow the user's manual. Quick replacement when there is small disturbance or failure. Some wear is absorbed in the gear blank, you have to immediately replace the gear. Proper maintenance procedure, following the proper maintenance procedure, accurate record of the failure. So you have to maintain the record about the lubricants, lubricant temperature, lubricant pressure, and what kind of additive we are using the lubrication, and how periodically we are replacing the lubricant, everything. We have to have accurate record about the maintenance procedure of the gear and the proper handling process for the gear. So these are all the some of the methods to minimize the gear failure. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures on the YouTube channel for all the mechanical engineering subject mentioned here. You subscribe the channel, use the video for your better preparation for examination. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. We'll meet again in another video on the design of transmission system